This is Shane Rogers reporting for the Weave News. We're here in Canton, New York. There is a rally that's been organized.
We're going to be right up to doing a human megaphone.
In protest to the ban.
Yeah, it is, because then you're actually recording.
Human microphone!
Human microphone!
All right, hello everyone!
Hello.
Welcome!
Welcome! Welcome.
Bienvenidos!
Bienvenidos!
Assalamu alaikum!
Alaikum assalam!
Bonjour!
Bonjour!
Shalom!
Shalom!
It's wonderful to see you all here!
It is wonderful to see you all here!
This gathering is taking place!
This gathering is taking place! On indigenous territory!
Let us remember that!
Let us remember that!
As we mobilize! In defense of the rights of immigrants! Long time North Country residents! Are you here?
I am here!
We see you and we welcome you!
We see you and we welcome you!
Those who've arrived more recently, are you here? Students who come from near and far, are you here?
We're here!
People whose ancestors survived the Middle Passage, are you here? Teachers, are you here? People who joined the women's marches, are you here? We see you and we welcome you all. Look around you. This is our community. We are many, we are strong. We are on the right side of history. We are here today. Because of the executive order. Targeting individuals.
Seven Muslim majority nations.
This order is illegal. It is immoral. It is unconstitutional.
Shameful.
And it will not stand. Yesterday evening, a federal judge. This is an important step. But it is not the end of the story. We must keep the pressure on. Are you with me? There are two reasons why we're here today. The first reason is to say no. No to the ban. No to Islamophobia.
No to xenophobia.
No to policies that seek to sow fear. No to any attempt to undermine our democracy. But we are also here to say yes. Yes to solidarity. Yes to religious freedom. Yes to communities that welcome immigrants and refugees. Yes to mutual support and the love of justice. Yes to the commitment. That those of us who are the least vulnerable.
Yes to the power of the people.
Yesterday, people mobilized all over this country.
Yesterday, people mobilized all over this country.
In major cities like New York and Los Angeles. Today, this mobilization continues. And from here, in our corner of the North Country. We join the chorus. No to hate, no to fear. Immigrants are welcome here. No to hate, no to fear. Immigrants are welcome here.
Say it loud. Say it clear.
Refugees are welcome here.
No
ban. Solidarity for all. No ban, no wall. Build bridges, not walls. This is what democracy looks like. Thank you to everyone. Who helped make this happen. I'm going to introduce the next speaker. Please welcome Ronnie Olesker Normanton.
Shane Rogers reporting live with the Weave News. We're watching a rally in Canton, New York.
I'm so inspired. There's so many people here. It's wonderful. When I look into the bright blue eyes of my daughter, which neither my husband nor I nor our family members share, I have to wonder. This is my Ukrainian genes that were wiped off the face of this planet. When some members of my family sought refuge in this country, they were denied.
When the ban was instated.
As I look look into my daughter's blue eyes. And wonder about a family tree erased from history. Because others dehumanize them for their religion. No, I will not watch my country do this. Let's stand together with our Muslim brethren. Let's not be silent. Let's stand high and tall and say, never again.
Live from Canton, New York, where a rally is organized to protest the ban recently enacted.
We're going to hear from two wonderful people. Please join me in welcoming Kathleen Buckley and Iram Amin.
What's going on here is that they're using the technique of the human microphone to repeat things that the speakers are saying, so they might be able to hear.
It's about being human.
We hold each other in a sacred trust.
We
hold each other in the sacred trust.
When we do our best to honor that trust.
When we do our best to honor that trust.
We care for one another.
We care for one another.
Right, Eric?
Yes. Thank you all for being here.
Thank you all for being here.
I am a Pakistani Muslim American.
I am a Pakistani Muslim American.
And I am trouble free.
And I am trouble free.
I came to U.S.
I came to U.S.
For a better life and better opportunities.
For a better life and better opportunities.
But for others.
But for others.
It is a matter of survival.
It is a matter of survival.
And we need to stand together.
And we need to stand together.
For their survival.
For their survival.
In the name of humanity.
In the name of humanity.
Regardless of religious differences.
Regardless of religious differences.
Thank you. And bless you all.
Thank you. Bless you all.
Live for the Weeb News, we're at a rally in Canton, New York, protesting the ban on immigrants that is recently enacted.
Please join me in welcoming Joseph Adriano.
Joseph Adriano.
The crowd here is using a technique where they're repeating what the speaker is saying so that everyone might be able to hear.
240 years ago,
the 240 years ago,
founders of our democracy set forth the core guiding principles of our nation. In the Declaration of Independence. They said that all men are created equal. And endowed by their Creator. With the rights to life.
Liberty.
And the pursuit of happiness.
All men.
And by that we mean men. Women.
Black.
White.
Gay.
Straight.
Muslim.
Christian. Immigrants.
Citizens.
All were given these rights by our Creator. And no one can take them from us. No man.
No government.
No president.
Turned his back on 240 years
of American values. By saying he will turn away at our border
with their eyes on this free shore
Men, women, and children.
Send them back into the arms.
Of murderers and extremists. He set himself at odds with everything we hold dear. I stand today to say that we stand by these values.
And the pursuit of happiness.
These are not rights that we can sleep on.
These are not rights that we can sleep on.
These are not rights that will protect themselves.
These are not rights that will protect themselves.
At Gettysburg. President Lincoln said that we must be dedicated to the great task. Remaining before us. So our nation shall have a new birth of freedom. And that this government of the people.
By the people.
And for the people. Will not perish from this earth. It is incumbent upon us. That every day we do at least one thing.
To protect our democracy.
Call your representatives. Network with like-minded people. Support the ACLU.
Southern Poverty Law Center.
Planned Parenthood.
NPR.
PBS. All the organizations that protect our freedoms. Support progressive candidates and run for office yourself. You know, today I stand here with that flag.
Because I love my country.
I love everything it stands for.
I love all its ideals.
Too long we have let people to whom these values mean nothing claim this symbol as their own.
To assure the survival and success of liberty.
If you will, I'd like to ask you to join me in a pledge of allegiance to our flag. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Liberty and justice for all. These values that we stand here today. Thank you. God bless all of us, and may God bless the United States of America.
This is the Weave News reporting live from Canton, New York.
Before I introduce our last speaker, some updates. According to the Guardian newspaper,
a spokesperson for the Department of Homeland Security
has confirmed that the ban applies.
To green card holders
from the seven countries named in the ban. A White House official has openly discussed
the idea of extending the ban
to other countries. Yesterday the ACLU challenged the executive order in court. as violating the due process.
As violating the due process.
And equal protection clauses of the U.S. Constitution.
And equal protection clauses of the U.S. Constitution.
Last evening, a federal judge. Issued a stay that partially blocks. The broader executive order. But stopped short of a broader ruling. On its constitutionality. Later last night. Another court in Boston. Issued a seven-day restraining order. Against the executive order. According to the Boston Globe. The ruling prohibits federal officials. From detaining or deporting immigrants and refugees. With valid visas or green cards. Or forcing them to undergo. Extra security screenings based on executive order. Two more.
A representative from the American Immigration Lawyers Association.
Told Al Jazeera that the fight continues. Quote, we are not going to rest. Until we make sure.
That the constitutional rights.
Of lawful permanent residents are respected. And that those who seek asylum on our shores. Are entitled and given. All the rights to seek that form of relief. Finally, I have a quote from Representative Elise Stefanik. Quote, I oppose President Trump's rushed and overly broad executive order. Keep the pressure on. All right, one more time. No to hate, no to fear. Immigrants are welcome here. Say it loud, say it clear. Refugees are welcome here. No ban, no wall. Solidarity for all. Build bridges, not walls.
Build bridges, not walls.
Thank you very much. Please join me.
In welcoming.
Reverend Sean Whitehead.
We come to remind each other that we ain't gonna let nobody turn us around.
Repeat after me, I ain't gonna let nobody turn me around.
I'm gonna keep on walking, keep on talking, marching.
Marching up to freedom land.
Have one quick choir rehearsal. Ain't gonna let nobody turn me around.
Ain't gonna let nobody turn me around.
I'm gonna keep on walking,
Keep on a talking, marching on to freedom land.
One more time.
Ain't gonna let nobody turn me around, turn me around, turn me around.
Ain't gonna let
nobody turn me around.
I'm gonna
keep on a walking, keep on a talking,
marching
up to freedom land.
Come on, do it again. Ain't gonna
let nobody turn me around, turn me around. Turn me around, ain't gonna let nobody turn me around.
I'm gonna
keep on walking, keep on talking, marching up to freedom land.
Ain't gonna
let nobody turn me around, turn me around, turn me around. Ain't gonna let nobody turn me around.
I'm gonna
keep on walking, keep on a talking, marching up to freedom land.
Come on, we're gonna say ain't gonna let racism, ain't gonna let xenophobia, ain't gonna let Islamophobia turn me around, turn me around. I'm gonna keep on what?
Walking.
Keep on what?
Talking.
Marching up to
freedom land.
Ain't gonna let racism, let's do that one.
Ain't gonna let racism turn me around, turn me around. Turn me around, ain't gonna let racism turn me around.
I'm gonna keep on walking,
keep on talking, marching up to freedom land.
Xenophobia?
Ain't gonna let xenophobia turn me around, turn me around, turn me around. Ain't gonna let xenophobia turn me around.
I'm gonna
keep on walking
and
keep on talking, marching up to freedom land.
Islamophobia?
Ain't gonna let Islamophobia turn me around, turn me around, turn me around. Ain't gonna let Islamophobia turn me around.
I'm gonna
keep on walking, keep on marching up to freedom land.
No wall! Ain't gonna let
no wall turn me around, turn me around. Turn me around, ain't gonna let no wall turn me around.
I'm gonna
keep on walking
and
keep on talking, marching up to freedom.
Last time, nobody
ain't gonna let nobody turn me around, turn me around, turn me around. Ain't gonna let nobody turn me around.
I'm gonna
keep on walking
and
keep on talking, marching up to freedom land. Woo!
Keep singing that song.
All right, thank you, everybody. You're beautiful.
You're beautiful.
You're beautiful. Disappear.
Should I write it down? Should I forward it to you?
I'm not sure how to do this.
If anybody has a mailing list for organizations, we come over here. There may be people who want to sign up.
Right? Sign up.
Thank you. Stay awake.
It's going on right now. Trying to think how
to tell. Anybody from Clarkson? Come on over for a second. Anybody from Clarkson? Yeah, what that one said. Right? Exactly.
Clarkson, come over here.
Okay.
There's some clipboards that are going to be going around for you to sign.
There's some clipboards going around for you to sign.
So that people can be kept in the loop.
So people can be kept in the loop.
And we can continue to work together.
And we can continue to work together.
So please don't leave until you've signed the clipboard.
So please don't leave until you sign the clipboard.
Thank you, my boy. done.
Thank you.
I'm texting him what should I say, how to get to his face. So but how would I tell him here? What should I say to him?
Johnny will know exactly. Recent executive order to ban Muslim immigrants.
Have a safe
So is this on the one that organized the event?
Where can I get your video?
It's streaming live right now.
Super. So it'll be.
And you were here organizing the event?
No, I'm not organizing the event. But my fiance Joe spoke, and I think he'll want it.
Yes.
Okay, great. Yeah. Yes, it is recorded live. Would you like to make a few comments to anybody out there?
Yes.
You have a sign here.
Yes. Is an excerpt of the I think this policy is truly unconscionable, un-American, and it's a core assault on our identity. This is a nation that welcomes all people to its shores. Yeah, thank you.
Mobilize. I'm recording live with the Weave News. Would anybody like to say anything today?
Oh, it's just, this is the silver lining we were just saying of, like, you know, this disgusting, you know, leader saying all the hateful things just out in the open, that it's got people mobilized, people who hate hatred and really, you know, showing the spirit of solidarity with the least vulnerable, I mean, the most vulnerable.
Right.
Yeah, great. It was great to see so many people at a moment's notice.
Great. And are you out here for any particular reason, for a particular person, or just to show support in general?
Staying for people who are too vulnerable to stand by themselves.
There's a lot of people who can't be here right now because of immigration, you know, who can't even leave the dairy farm. That's what I'm here for right now, you know.
To stand up and make sure everyone in our community feels safe and welcome.
Thank you. Excuse me, I'm recording live with the Weave News. And I would just like to ask you a couple questions about, well, first you have your sign and you gave a speech today.
I did.
Yeah, so can you tell me your thoughts about what's happening here today?
I think it's wonderful. We have to gather. We have to stand against these kinds of pronouncements that are both illegal and don't make any sense for how we move forward as a nation or as a world dealing with the pressing problems. So I'm so grateful for everyone present and for the people that spoke and for those who organized it.
Yes, it seemed like a very quick response to the executive order. Were you involved in organizing the event as well?
Just getting the word out to some students and talking with John Collins, of course, the primary organizer, about, you know, trying to get a song and a few words together.
Great. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Hello. Do you mind if I interview you quickly for the Weave News?
Yes,
sure. Yes. So I saw you talk today.
Yes.
And could you tell us a little bit about where you're from and your experience?
So I am from Pakistan. I'm from Pakistan. And and I moved to the United States in 2009. And I'm a U.S. citizen. And I just want to represent solidarity with like other Muslim countries, and it's just bad. Like, we, America doesn't stand for hatred. We have like our founders, like founders of America, they set this country, established this country with certain values, and we have to like preserve those values, and we can't let Donald Trump take that away from us. Yeah. And we, the voices of people, are like we are stronger than him, and I think we can really make a difference. And we have already made a difference, I think, standing here together, representing America, the voice of America.
Yeah. So what do you think about this?
I was pleased. I'm so happy that, like, so many people are here to support, like, their Muslim brethren. I wasn't expecting it to be so many people. It was such a great turnout. And I'm so pleased and happy. I'm feeling satisfaction.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for being here, too.
Good, how are you?
Good. Kind of trusting that, you know, I mean, there are a lot of people out there.
Hello, I'm reporting live with the Weave News. I noticed your signs, and I was hoping maybe you would want to tell me a little bit about them and why you're here today.
I think if he takes the rights from one person, he's going to try to take the rights from all of us, and we need to start it before it begins first.
Yeah, everybody has rights. I mean, we have to stand up for everybody. I mean, not everyone has a voice.
She's a veteran.
Yeah.
She didn't fight for
this. This is not what I'm for. I mean, I fight for everybody. I don't care what they look like, purple, yellow. I don't care where they're from. I fight for everybody. I'm not letting some person just come in and destroy all that.
Great.
It's not going to happen.
Great. And what do you think about the turnout here? And
I'm loving this. All kids, different kinds of people.
We almost went to New York City, but then we heard about this one, so we came up here.
Wow, that's a big trip.
Yes. We're from Syracuse. So.
Two and a half hours. So. Wow.
Okay.
We have something. Someone's got to.
Great. Thank you very much.
Why don't we just move my voice?
Oh, really?
Yeah, she's over this way.
Hello. I, even people from our bus, like, we were getting off the train at the same time. It was 5 of us. We lost 2 people. Like,
yeah, right.
Excuse me, I'm reporting live with the Weave News, and I'm wondering if you would mind making a comment about maybe your sign and why you're here?
Sure. Well, you want to see the other side? Here's the other side. I'm here because I believe that the executive order is absolutely horrific. It is not a reflection of what I or all of these people, many more who are here or not here, what we believe in and care about. And we believe that all people are welcome in our communities, and we're here to say so. And we're not going to stop pushing back until that executive order is lifted.
My name is the Reverend James Galzinski. I'm a minister at the UU Church across the street. And for me and my congregation, it's our moral imperative to welcome the stranger. It's been a doctrine taught amongst early Judaism to Christianity, and it needs to be upheld and lifted up right in this moment.
And what do you think about the turnout here today? It seems to be a wide variety of people and a large number of people today.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. It's exciting to see. Yes, absolutely. And you know, that's important. That's an important message. We will come together, and we will come together again and again as we need to.
Hey, how are you?
Thank you very much.
And there's not an international airport that's close by to.
Yeah.
Well, Augsburg, but that.
Yeah.
But yeah. That's,
yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I guess you can. Yeah. I guess you can.
sings for us.
Excuse me?
Oh, yes, I am going to come to that one.
Pardon me. I'm recording live with the Weave News, and I was wondering if you would be willing to say something about your sign and why you're here today?
Okay. Well, I'm here because I believe, as somebody who recognizes difference, that that is what makes our country great. And I think it's a horrible tragedy for us to close the door on people who may be different from us. And I think that this president has done so in violation of the Constitution. I'm not even sure if he's ever read it. It would behoove him to do so.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm here. I'm here because I believe that this is a country of immigrants. Most of us immigrated here, or our ancestors did, and I don't understand why we would think that we could stop that now. Why would we stop anyone else from that same opportunity?
And what do you think about the turnout here today?
I'm excited about the turnout. We're growing. Right, we're not getting tired, we're getting stronger, and we're getting energized.
Great.
I'm excited.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Are you cold? How
are you?
Hello. I'm recording live with the Weave News. Would you like to say something on?
Yes. Lou supports immigration rights.
Great. Great. Thank you.
Sorry, my words kind of gone.
Hello.
Hi,
I'm recording live with the Weave News, and I'm wondering if you want to say something maybe about your sign and why you're here today?
Yeah, absolutely.
Great.
I mean, it just happened so quickly. Everything started yesterday, and it's just amazing to see how many local people come out and stop their plans to fight for the injustices that are happening right now. It's crazy. You see all different types of people here today, which is just wonderful.
Oh, yeah. So the sign is basically saying that we're all just a piece of the puzzle, right? And including this protest is around one issue, but it should be thought of as just a piece in the puzzle of the kind of bigger struggle to achieve different kinds of liberations. So this is one piece.
Yeah. Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So are you.
Maybe you can get some Montreal.
Guys filming.
Hello. I'm recording live with the Weave News, and I'm wondering if you might want to say something about your signs and about why you're here today.
Just happy to support.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.
Hello, I'm recording live with the Weave News. I'm wondering if you might want to say something about why you're here today, maybe, about your sign.
Yes, I'm from Bangladesh. I've been in this country for 32 years, and I always considered this my home until recently. So I just want to let people know that this is our home. Yes, we love this country just as much as any other.
What about direct?
Great.
More emerging, maybe more confirmed. If he don't love America, definitely.
I mean, like, this is how not you make people put together. Like, my kids are born here. They went to school here. They went to college here. Just because their skin is brown, now they are in fear. You know, like, it's hard to watch them constantly being audited, like, watching news and keeping on saying that, what is going to happen? This is terrible. But it's so wonderful to see all the people here who believe in...
That's the best thing.
Yes,
that's like, the best America. That's what America is.
This is the America that we know.
Yes. And there's quite a number and variety of people here, too. Were you surprised of the people who turned out today? Or?
Oh, yes.
Yes, we thought only 50 people. Yeah, it's 500, more than 500 people here.
We are just wondering in the car that if anybody's going to show up, but it's heartwarming to see how people are... Like, this is the America I know.
Thank you very much.
So we're in this packed group, trying to group stay. We're going in.
This is Shane Rogers reporting live with the Weave News. We're here in Canton, New York, where a rally has organized to protest Donald Trump's recent executive order to ban Muslims from immigrating from seven key countries. And it seems as if there may be others on the way. We're making our way around the crowd and interviewing a few people to see why they're here and to get their opinions.
Are you all signed up?
I'm here with the Weave News, and I see that you're helping people get signed up. You want to tell me a little bit about why you're here today and what part of the action that you're in today?
I am following the crowd. I just learned about the march at 11:59, and I came out here and saw lots of people I know, and I'm very encouraged, and I'm feeling like maybe this is going to be a weekly event, so I'm looking forward to getting an email about it. But beyond that, I can't tell you much.
Okay, great. Thank you. Excuse me, sir. I'm with the Weave News, and I'm recording live.
Yeah.
And I see you have a sign here. It says, America equals freedom for all religions.
Yes.
And I'm wondering if you might be willing to tell me why you're here and what this sign means for you.
I'm here in protest of our current president, Donald Trump. I do not like his policy towards Islam and towards the countries that he has ordered.
Okay, and there's a large number of people here congregated with you. Did you expect to see a large turnout like this, or?
Judging from what I saw last night, I expected a fair crowd, but I wasn't expecting this size.
Okay. Great. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Yes! Yes!
Hello, I'm recording live with the Weave News, and I'm wondering if you might want to say a few words about your sign and about why you're here today.
Sure. Well, I have friends here that are from another country, and we love them. We love people from all around the world, and they are no threat to us. And this is to help understand that people who really follow Jesus will care about the least of these. They won't just care about the top 1% or fraction of a percent. They will care about everyone, especially the refugee who is fleeing from danger. Jesus was a refugee, and we should care about those who are in peril.
And what do you think about the turnout here today?
Well, I'm very pleased that there's, even in a small community, that we can say, have our say about what we believe is right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'm sorry.
This is Shane Rogers. I've been recording with the Weave News here in Canton, New York, where Ali has organized to protest Donald Trump's executive order. And we've been walking around in the crowd after the speakers from the rally and taking interviews with people to get some opinions on why they're here and what they feel about the executive order. I'm recording live with the Weave News.
Oh, hi!
And I'm wondering if you might want to say a little bit about your sign and why you're here today.
I'm here because what has been passed by the president is un-American. A Muslim ban goes completely contrary to the 1965 Immigration and Nationality Act that says we cannot discriminate people from immigrating to our country based on race, religion, or ancestry. So I'm here to remind our president that there is an act that makes whatever his executive order was unconstitutional.
Great.
Thanks.
And what do you think about the turnout today?
I think it's an amazing turnout. I heard about it late last night, and to see all these people here practicing what democracy is, it's very heartwarming and it's very comforting to know that we have a lot of support in the community.
Great. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Hello. Bye.
What are you doing?
I'm recording live with the Weave News.
That's
good. Would you like to make a comment about why you're here today?
I'm here today. Everybody knows about it, to protest. That's it.
Great. Yes. And what do you think? What do you think of the turnout here?
This is amazing. Yeah.
Great.
It cannot be any better than this. We are all united. That's what it means. That's it.
Thank you. Bye.
They're trying to do a day
Hello, I'm recording live with the Weave News, and I'm wondering if you might want to make a comment about why you're here today.
Sure. I'm here today to support everyone I know, especially students that I work with who identify as Muslim or come from the countries that were part of the ban and who would be affected by the law.
And so are you working at a school here?
I work at St. Lawrence.
Okay, great. And what do you think about the turnout here today?
I'm really excited by the turnout here today.
I'm here today to also for the support. I'm a permanent resident in New York State, also Muslim. So being here today and hearing what people have to say is very inspiring.
So that's my life.
I have hope. So
I'm
excited about the turnout too.
Great.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you very much.
He's jumping jacks,
All right, and with that, I think we'll finish the broadcast. This is Shane Rogers. We've been reporting live from Canton, New York, where a rally is organized to protest Donald Trump's executive order to ban Muslim immigrants and refugees from the U.S. We'll be recording live again in the near future. Thank you for tuning in. Goodbye.